Welcome back, everybody. I am Quagdarr.
Adopt the Bright Paw and support Make-A-Wish. From now until December 31st, 100% of the Bright Paw adoption fee will go to support Make-A-Wish. Now, I love when Blizzard Entertainment does things like this because I get behind that one 100%. This is one of my favorite charities that they have out there. So we're going to go ahead and have Quagdarr get one of these babies and have one of these wonderful Bright Paws follow us around. And to make it double special, we're going to donate a second time so I can go ahead and get a code to then go ahead and put it in the video, as per usual, for you guys to go ahead and enjoy. So to whoever finds the code in the video, have fun. Ah! It's a wonderful charity, and if you guys are looking to donate to any charities, I highly recommend checking out the Make-A-Wish Foundation. It really does go towards a wonderful cause.
Santa's coming to town!
Santa!
The baddest soul in town on base.
Dark. We are going to go here.
His line is always busy.
Get one! Got one!
Fear my moo of fury!
For a horde! We bring it down to work, snake us from the town. So turn it up for all the dwarves around. We get reward drops to break the ground. You're one of us, then please make the following sound. We bring it down to work, snake us from the town.
No!
That's an amazing song. It really is. That song was just absolutely just ballin' right there. Yeah, Horde Pride.
Horde Pride.
Horde Pride.
Horde Pride.
All right, so now, where did we pick up? So last we played was 3 years ago, and let's see, where are we going right now? I'm trying to find, yes, that's right, he's frozen in there. Did somebody just kill the quest guy? Are you serious? Oh my god, they did. All right, well there's that. So we're off to a banging start on this wonderful holiday edition of World of Warcraft, Let's Level a Horde. This is our final episode for the Burning Crusade. Next time we see it, it's going to be, you know, deeper into wintertime, and we'll be appropriately enough in Winterspring. Not Winterspring. We'll be appropriately enough in Northrend. Like Northrend. Northrend's one of my favorite zones in the entire game. Probably, it's like my top. It's between Northrend and the Burning Crusade. Those are my two faves.
My two faves!
What do I have to kill something? Gotta have to read the quest. I see a quest. I see a couple quests, and I like that. And one of the things we're gonna do to go ahead and kickstart this wonderful episode is first toast you guys, the viewers, with a nice little eggnog with just a splash of cognac. Now, I did commit a cardinal sin by using the XO. You should never do that. If you are mixing, never use the XO, but it was all I had. So we're just gonna go ahead and go with that. Just a small splash, and we're also going to go ahead and elevate ourselves so we no longer get hammered. Yes, that's nice. Just nice little touch of bite right there. Yes, just a bit of the cognac flavor to come through. Very, very light. And we're going to go ahead and be playing this one a little bit more while we have our little nice little Bright Paw pet with us. Gotta like him. He's a hoot. And actually, I think it kind of works appropriately, because we're in Netherstorm, and they have all this arcane energy, apparently, with them, so we'll take that all day long. I'm assuming we're escorting this knucklehead, because I just really was not in the mood to read quests. Proceed. Indeed, proceed. Yes. So where we last left off was around Halloween, and goodness gracious me. Seriously, the holiday season really begins right around Halloween, and it's just nonstop. Little vacation there, if you saw the vlog. Now, I've never gifted one of these little pets in-game before, so I'm hoping they just go ahead and send a code or something like that I can go ahead and give you guys, the viewers, and go ahead and take home and enjoy this wonderful little Make-A-Wish Foundation pet. If you don't find them, and you do want them, but you want the proceeds to go to Make-A-Wish Foundation, again, wonderful charity, highly recommended, you got till December 31st. Because right now, usually Blizzard used to do 50% of the proceeds would go to Make-A-Wish. Now, for this particular one, it's 100%. So I like that. That type of stuff is just, that's just, I love when they do that.
Yes, I need the crystals! Okay, oh, he's coming down here. Like a big crotch shield on him. Yes, hurry up, Mr. Robot.
Okay, yes, let's go through the cavern, or like, let's go through the ridge right here where we have no defense. Smart thinking. Smart thinking, Blinken. Oh, look at the wolf and the kitten. Aww.
Come on. Just come on. Come on.
Ah, another storm. Yes, this is where a lot of the in-game content from the original Burning Crusade would take place. Fantastic stuff. This is also the zone where you can go ahead and get the famous Phoenix mount from one of the bosses. I believe he is in this one raid called the Eye. The Eye. And that's actually a boss fight where everybody, you know, we like the orange color text, you know, legendaries. That's the only raid that everybody, you have to use legendaries in order to beat him. But yeah, everybody would go ahead, grab a legendary real quick, and that was the one way to go ahead and beat Kael'thas. I think it's Kael'thas. A lot of the names are escaping me, because it's just, I really haven't associated my character with those other NPCs in a long friggin' time. So, are we done here? Is this it? Are you done, Mr. Robot? Because I know I still gotta go back up in there. Thank you. Goodness. Mark 5's live. Mark 5, like Johnny 5. Who is Johnny? That is from the movie Short Circuit. Okay, yeah. I need this crystal here, dang it. Just let me go ahead and kill you now, and we can go ahead and move on. I like the way he zips around. That's funny. He reminds me of my dog, Remy. He zips around. He gets into those hyper modes, and all of a sudden he likes to go ahead and turn into Speed Racer and race around the house. It's the most annoyingly cute thing you've ever seen. Oh, okay, we need batteries. Now we need batteries. Freaking engineers. Oh, go ahead and pick up some double A's from over here, I'm assuming. Why is this way down here? And we'll go ahead and turn these quests in. Ho, ho, ho. Merry Christmas! Okay, where do we have to go here? The second day of our recording session! Let's see here. What we're gonna do, we're gonna kick this off with the dungeon. Let's just go ahead and do that. I wanna do a dungeon. What do we have here? Specific dungeons? What have we not done? We've done Escape from Dirnhold. That was fun. Let's go ahead and queue up for any of those. Get our little bright paw out.
Mount up!
That's right. We'll... Ooh, wow, that was quick. I like it. Yes. It's the holidays, so I would imagine a lot of people are off right now. Makes it easier to find dungeon groups.
Hammer time! Stop! Hammer time! Oh.
I got one enchanter. That's Baba Ganoush. He's my only enchanter that I ever actually leveled because it was such a pain in the butt back in the day. I think I don't know if it's a little easier. I wouldn't imagine that it is. It was always a pain in the butt to get the materials. It's kind of why I started to go with more gathering type of professions. You can make money just by selling those things to people that need it. You may see my eye occasionally glance over to the right, as well as the little video screen look much sharper. This is just kind of A, it's a little test, and B, a little bit more fun for the holidays. I'm just going to go ahead and use the DSLR for the game video of me playing this so I can spend my time with you guys while I play. But also I'm looking to the right because I have this little monitor right there that gives me a far better idea of where my focus is. So it's seeing this real big monitor right there, it's just drawing my eye. So I have to get used to it. Oh my god, the giant robot! And keep running! And oh my god, the thorium cloak. Yes, I remember getting that during my tanking days. I loved it. Oh, okay, we're doing a full clear. So this'll take a while.
Hurry, 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 hurry!
And, oh, okay, I vaguely remember her. This particular boss, she goes ahead and she has this big fire thing. So when you're tanking, you're supposed to kind of drag her around, kiting, just to have her follow you all the way around so nobody gets hit. Take out the ads first. Yes, yes!
Yes!
Good times.
Our little wolves.
Ah, this one drops the tanking sword, the Sun Eater. Really cool looking weapon. Let's go ahead and give this guy all kind of love.
Yes, give him my little wolf pack. Yes, listen to daddy.
Uh-huh.
Yes, get him, Wolfie.
Boom! Mechanard done!
Mechanard done!
Okay. Now we have to go over here and we gotta kill somebody. Okay, this is what we need to do. Where is he at? Are you here? Where's the servo? Annihilator. Anybody? Where you at?
You can do it, Quagdarr! You can do it! You're the best around!
And we're just gonna blow every cooldown that we have, just to be certain. Now, we should be able to kick some ass, because... Windshield! Boom. Okay, I like that, and I like my wolves. The wolves are...
Follow the me! I'm the pack leader!
That's awesome. I like that. I want those guys to be permanent. Maybe there's a glyph for that, and if not, there should be. Blizzard, if you're listening, do it.
Do it. Just do it. Just do it.
Okay. Do it. Mm-hmm. Do it.
All right.
Do I need, like, a device for this? Do I have anything that's like,
use this device?
Yes, come here, Mr. Giant Stingray. Ooh. You can see why they wanted to take flying out of the game. Look at all those bad guys that I can try and avoid.
No!
Apparently these are rare items. Why is their text white? You're teasing me. And yes!
Finally!
Finally, it has happened to me. All right, here we are, kids. We've discovered the runes. Runes. Item is not ready yet. Come on, seriously? Why the hell is it not ready yet? Shouldn't it be, like, instantly ready? I want to see the cooldown on this thing. 30 seconds? All right, so basically go use the bathroom between these. these things right here. And we'll try and finish out this stinger thing. That should take us to level 68. And we'll be done with that. Absolutely, we will. After we complete this, will we level? No. Yes, we are taking that one. And in the meantime, we're going to head into the Botanica. Oh! I don't think I ever showed you guys. While we're walking through, check it out. Look at that. This is... Let's see. That should be a route right there. Yeah. This is a 3D... It's a little 3D me and my baby. Little sculpture. We went to a convention and they had that stuff there. And did we just level by doing nothing? Ha ha! That's awesome. Wow, I should grab that little statue more often if that's what triggers it. I like it. Boy, this is like a speed run. Ah. Utgard Keep. That is the first dungeon in the Wrath of the Lich King. But, continuing tradition. We're not going to touch anything regarding that until we hit level 70. So, let's go ahead and turn this guy in. Probably one more little round. Maybe we'll go ahead and finish up the Wrath of the Lich King. This particular episode over here in Shadow Moon Valley. And I don't think we did much in Terrakar. No, we bypassed Terrakar altogether. So that's one of the things we'll do. Go ahead and hit up Shadow Moon Valley. That one was fun. I enjoyed that one a lot. Oh my god. Alright, this was one of those where you could tell Blizzard... You can kind of see some of the design aspects come through where they're like, well, we need to have a collect quest. We kind of got to slow them down so it's like a grind because we don't have that many quests. Kill quest. How many? 10. Sounds good. Feels like when you kill them one at a time, you get more of the little insignias. So let's test that theory. Okay. Does it continue the trend? Yes, it does. We're going to turn those in and start heading over to Shadow Moon Valley. Now, I like Shadow Moon Valley. Now we've traveled for a while. We've discovered the Twisting Mether.
Yes. Oh, somebody wants the Santa hat. Yeah, you do. Oh, you do. Okay, go frolic and play.
Okay, all kind of craziness, but if you look around, we are here at Shadow Moon Valley. That's right. This is the land where Illidan presides, and way back in the distance over yonder, that's where he is at. And even in a dreadful place like this, you can still have the holidays. Look at all these quests. That's delicious. Tons of group quests, so I don't really know if we're going to be able to do those group quests. But you know what? We're not going to have that bother, so we're just going to have a good old time with that, and let's go ahead and kill some Infernals. Because we like doing that. Ooh, here we go. Yes. See, this is the trick, is you got to catch them enough when they're, like, I think over 50% or something like that in order to get the credit. Get the cred. Yes. Who did I get him? Yes! Yes! There we go. We got 10 of those. Yes! I like it. Where's my little guy at? He just kind of... He was showing that he was around, but we didn't have him out. Okay. Yes, more ash. I need more ash. Excuse me. Let me collect this mini volcano. I was asked to do this. I don't know why. Won't make sense. But I'm being asked to do this. Can I come inside your half barrel, sir? Or your home? How come the little pigeons take more hits? How's that work? Goodness, piggy! You're just upset because I'm here to exterminate you. And I guess I understand that. I suppose if I had some giant hulking green orc dude coming at me with two massive hammers with lightning bolts shooting out of his ass, I would probably be upset too. It's all about perspective. Life is all about perspective. This little piggy got hit with a hammer. This little piggy got knocked the out. Yeah. My God, really? Why 20? Are they that? Is it that big of an infestation? Seriously. This is also the zone, by the way. I'm flying around. Just put on the Nether Drake right there. Where you get the Nether Drake? There's like a little island over down here. That's where you go ahead and get them. You have to get exalted with them. It takes a little bit, but once you do, it's now account-wide. Since we're over here, we'll turn the quests in. Because maybe they may give us others. I forgot. I still have this on my old character, Brutalis. These guys right here, you cannot see them unless you have on these little goggles, like these spectrals. And those are pretty cool to go ahead and have. So you get to fight things that normally you would never see. Only bad thing is we have to take off the tarnished helmet. So we got to remember to put that on, considering I like to go ahead and hide the helmet. Eat hammers. Here. Take your stuff. Ah, the Black Morass. This one's really cool. There's a bunch of things that you have to go ahead and kill, so you're like running around. But basically, this takes you back in time to the opening of the Dark Portal. So this one's really, really cool. Opening of the Dark Portal. Ah, yes, see? And yes, there we go. Similar to the epicness of Dernhold, cool lore. This one's very cool lore. Medivh. He's going to be in the World of Warcraft movie, or the Warcraft movie. So, that's pretty cool. Kill this jabron. Now, we just basically got to keep an eye out for those things, those dragons that come through the portal. That's the catch, is you're constantly on the lookout. Oh. Oh, 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 over there! See how it's like running back and forth. Yes, wolf power! Ah, that's the bronze. Notice the color of the dragons. They all have different things. The bronze dragon flight. I want to say they deal a lot with, like, time travel, so you'll see a lot of them like dealing with time. Then they have the red, the black, the green, and the blue, and all that. I kind of forgot what the different dragon flights are called. The dragon flights really are. But then you have the what is it, queen? I don't know. She's up in Northrend. I forgot her name right now. She's the queen mother of all dragons. No, Mr. Half Dragon Man. You're not gonna do anything. Funny thing is, in episode one, we were having to just fight, like, you know, a wolf or a fox or a frog or a turtle or something like that. Now look at what we's fighting. All right, where are we at here? Look at the dark portal over there. I'm assuming back in the day they had cosmetic changes, because it looks nothing like that now. Big and dragon, goodness, I'm in the butt.
Get them, my little wolfmen. So OP. Whoa, hey now.
Here comes the orcs. The Shadow Council. Azeroth's right for the taking. Ah, Medivh, you
where to bear witness to the opening of the Dark Portal.
That's kind of cool. We got, like, I'm assuming, like, a Latin tank up here. It's awesome. Oy. So we probably lost about 20 minutes of recording. Again, gang, gonna go ahead and try and edit this together as best as possible, but just in case the recording glitched up there, which is why I'm gonna go back to exclusively using Marilla's action to record everything, including the little one of me. We hit level 69, which is fantastic. So of that, I apologize. Definitely been a confusing experience. So again, I'm going to go ahead and mention it because I don't know if it was picked up. And again, I apologize for that. This craziness. Since we're almost done with the Burning Crusade, if you are the ones that leave comments and you want to continue to leave comments, which I appreciate and thank you very much for doing that, from what you have either seen or experienced personally, what is your favorite zone in the Burning Crusade? Go ahead and tell me in the comments. I'm really curious to hear that. As well as in what we call Vanilla WoW. I'd really love to know that. What is your favorite zone in Vanilla as well? I understand some of you guys may be torn. So go ahead and, you know, list two if you want. Trust me, there's a lot. There's a lot out there, so. Isn't that cool? I bet that would look amazing in 3D or virtual reality. Just go down like forever. Go ahead and set you guys on fire if you don't mind. Alrighty, here we go. Take it, lady. Boom! Ooh, also at level 70, it just occurred to me. We get to use the Champion of the Renew title. It's a title you can't get anymore. So that's kind of why I like it. Besides, it looks cool. I like it. You have upset me and my doggies. Move this, 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 and that's where we are. We're off with the totems.
With the totems.
Okay, here we go. Boom! Come on, attack him. Hello? There we go. Little bit of lag to catch up there. All right, there we are. We're getting there. We are getting there. What's over here? And now we need the right paw. And now we need our purple netherwing drake. So where's some more stone people, dang it? Die, small boulder man. Okay, there we are. Dungeons are an absolute blast, and I love the way Random Lich King dungeon. We're just so far up in there that that's going to be what it's going to try and give us. And let's see, the Architrez, Magisteer's Terrace. I'd really like to try and see if we can do Magisteer's Terrace, but I don't want to block us at the same time. Sure, with that, we're just going to go ahead and look for those and hope we get that. That would be nice. That was in the little added dungeon area. Magisteer's Terrace, where you can go ahead and get the title of the Shattered Sun if you get exalted and you pay an obscene amount of gold. So that's okay. How the heck am I gonna? Oh, look at all the elementals out here. Look to R&D. It's very appropriate that we're doing quests that require totems. Yes, you. There you go. Come on back over here, sir. What? How the heck did you hit me? Let's do my spirit walk. Yeah! Frankly, it makes no sense. And I agree with that, because I don't know what we're doing over there. Do I have to use another device that's taking up valuable bag space? I want you to travel to the lava flow near the ruins of Barcra And use the... I knew it. Dang it. I knew it. Okay. Where's this item at? And if you look to your left over here, that's the Black Temple. That's where Illidan hangs out. Right there. Right in front of us. We're looking right at it. And there's a little crack right in that, in the bottom of that base there. And that's where you would go in to kind of enter it, since the doors are shut and, you know, locked. You have to make your way in.
Okay, here we go. I want you over here, too. Let's kill them all. Here we go. I've killed the whole base.
Now, how come he dropped a light feather, but yet they don't drop these feathers? Obviously, they drop some form of a feather. Doesn't make sense to me. Woo! Magister's Terrace. That's the exact one I was hoping we would get, and we're already not because somebody declined it. Oh my god, it took. Holy hell. Jeez Louise. Okay. Didn't think it would. And I'm glad that we did get this one, because this one, it's a much different in terms of what the dungeons look like. So, this is good. I somewhat remember this one. Howdy, howdy. Yeah, you guys keep everything. I don't care. Yeah, this was one where, when it first came out, you would have a lot of crowd control that was going on in the game. Like, you just saw that this one particular character was sheeped by the mages, and you really had to. But then Blizzard was like, it's too hard, and then all of a sudden people started out-gearing it, this whole dungeon, and they would just bring in everything. They would just, like, grab everyone and just pull everything at once. I believe this one also drops a mount. You can get the white little, like, bird. I don't know. It's not my cup of tea. Like, literally, if it dropped, somebody else would probably appreciate it more. So I doubt seriously I would even care for it. Ah, we're already at the first boss. And you're dead.
Yes!
See, that right there, that statue is of, I think, Kel'thas. That's the... technically the last boss. That right there is the sneak peek of the raid. But we are going to cancel that. Yes. Yeah, so see over there, that's where the raid is.
Fate of the world hangs in the balance.
Does it? All right. Well, we like that. Ooh. Oh, look, our first epic quest. This was when they started having, in the Burning Crusade, gems. So you can go ahead and, you know, like, have socketed items, and you would have epic gems. So that was always fun to go ahead and get that. Anything epic was always a treat to get. You know, at the current raid, I think we're going to go ahead and be dinging 70 at the end of this raid, or probably even just before it, you know, we don't know. We'll see. Oh, I'm looking so forward for us getting into the Wrath of the Lich King, because the dungeons in the Wrath of the Lich King are really well done. Yeah, that's going to be fun. Except for, and you'll see it, I'm probably knowing our luck, the Oculus. I never really enjoyed this one called the Oculus. It's just a pain in the butt. Oh, and we are getting rep with the Sun Offensive. Or the offensive sun. There you go, Mr. Troll. I like it. It's a group of uglies, no blood elves. Got the undead, the trolls, the orcs, and a goblin. So that sounds okay to me. Yeah, we're totally going to be leveling because we still have quests to do. Now, if I recall, for this particular fight, you get trapped in bubbles and you have to, like, you fly around. So you're not just on a two-dimensional plane when you fight. You're flying around in a three-dimensional fight. Here, let's get a good shot of him. Leader, oh, Lord of the Blood Elves. Burn him down! Now, at a certain percentage, he should go ahead and start freaking out. And I think that's where it is. Yeah. Ooh. Yeah. And ooh, that guy's got some good stuff right there. So that's awesome. That's I guess kind of cool. And gang, we hit level 70. That means the Burning Crusade is done. It is done. That's correct. And the next time we go ahead and continue on, we'll be in the Wrath of the Lich King, where we board the boat, and we'll have fun with that. Gonna be a hoot and a holler. Hallelujah, level 70 in 3 episodes. Well, gang, it's been a wonderful final episode for this holiday season. It's my holiday episode. I wanted to get this one out a little faster, but this worked out better for the end because since it's supposed to be a holiday episode, we are going to be able to go ahead and all together include getting the gifts from Great Father Winter. That's the Santa Claus of orcs. So this is going to be fun. I really wanted to go ahead since I was a little bit behind in the edit with some technical issues. So this works out in the better for us because we never really got to see Orgrimmar decorate for the holidays, what you're seeing right now with all the lights and the wreaths spread everywhere. So let's go ahead and delve into our gifts. Yes. Yes. Bring. Oh, no, that's a quest. Santa, you can keep that. I just want the gifts. So, one. Woo, he knows if you've been naughty. All right, what did we get? Anything good? Let's see here. Teaches you how to summon this companion, a red helper box. We like that. Let's go ahead. So we got a little pet from Santa. Every holiday, you have to wait for the actual December 25th morning to occur, and all the presents under the tree will become active. So it's, you know, Christmas time. Oh, dress up your perky pug. Okay, so you know what? We're going to go ahead and we're going to do that real quick.
Hello.
Yes! Look at him. That's a oh my god, he's got a red nose too. let's see, what else we got? Woo, somebody likes me. Time flies when you're having fun.
Boom.
Yes, and preserved holly.
Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah.